Hi guys, welcome back to Virtual Pool 4 Blog. It's Mal here, and we are here today to play some 10 ball. And straight away we get the 10 ball. I'm not sure if it's called pocket. It could be 1-0 up. We'll wait and see. It might be spotted. Yep, it is. Right, so I tried to play a little bit of snooker, guys, and I was abysmal. I mean really abysmal, not just kind of abysmal. I hope you like the new overlay. I am still using the green screen, but just thought I would try something new today. Yeah, everything's going well. I've now lost a couple of stone, which is about 28 to 30 pounds in weight. So I'm doing okay. And today we're playing Mad Max in a race to six. Now Mad Max is very, very good, so don't expect any favours of him if you play him. You've really got to be running out when you get the chance. This 10 might go near the pocket, but I'm putting a little bit of running right on it just to make sure the white ends up on this side of the table. If anything, I've made my life a bit harder there. But against the best computer opponents, you guys know fine well that you have to run out as many, you know, all of your chances. I'm a little bit thin here. Hope I don't mess it up. I haven't. And we've now got just swing it two cushions back in the middle of the table for the 10 in the bottom. I believe we'll have to call the pockets on the 10s because it's a call shot game. 1-0. So break and run for the first rack. And that white ball will be close. Have you got any friends? No. So break and dish and then a bad break. So he's pushed out. The red is busted up and so I'm gonna give that one back just because I didn't have a clear shot at it. And of course Mad Max opens the entire rack up with a worldy shot that I just didn't see. And that looked like it was gonna miss just for that horrible moment. And then he plays safe, so he ducks. That's quite interesting. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to jump into the cut safe, just to be technical. Cut safe, like that. Jump into the cut safe. There you go. That's a free one. Another one for free. I'm using a filter on my webcam, if you find that interesting. That's good as well. So in a bit of a cat and mouse game. I like these when the computer plays a bit of cat and mouse. Oh dear. Got away with that. Well, I say I did, but let's wait and see what he does. Whew. So Mad Max is playing tight. Here I'm just going to try and sit on the three. Obviously I've got to hit a cushion. I've hit that far too hard. And... could play the plan. That wasn't a good shot. That wasn't what I wanted. I wanted that shot, but a lot less. Look at Mad Max just tying me up. It's great. I love it. I love this game. Right, we're going to go off the cushion this time because the four's stuck, so even if we miss... Well, this could be ridiculous. Oh, my goodness. How did that stay out? Let's have a look at that again. Just watch this. Oh no, view. Watch this. How did that even stay out? Let's go from this angle. Phew. Madness. Right, now we're gonna go for the four here. This takes judgment in terms of what angle. And I might have gone straight enough. Not bad. So here I'm just gonna play with right hand side. I don't think I can hold for it. I'll come off really thin possibly. What am I doing? Well, why not just play the shot? Mad Max is giving me nothing here. Alright, it's gotta be a jump. Line up your tip because that's always the first thing the computer tries to nail you on. Oh, might not be able to reach here. Can't reach. Oh, So eventually the computer fashions out first opportunity. I'm tying my top so I'm not like those attractive Twitch people who get told off for revealing too much. I'm sure I'm not going to have that chance. That does not want to drop, and that's bad news for Mad Max. However, I'm expecting another worldy safety of him. Not a worldy safety, but very difficult to come off. So what I'm going to do is hit it thin with lots of side and go behind the nine. Or not behind the nine, but I always had that insurance of the eight ball. So we may get first dibs here. And we have. So that this is the first real opportunity, and you saw how hard I had to work to get it. Rode our luck a few times, but hopefully now that means we've now managed to secure this rack for our side of the scoreboard. Hit that too hard, but it doesn't matter. Same pocket for the 10. That was a bit wider than I thought. So we're going to go a little bit wide for the break to see if we can nail it and get any friends down. We're not going to get any friends unless the three helps us. Go on, three. Nope. 2-0. And I feel these. It's like that, is it? Prison rules. 2-1. Time for the jump stick. I'm going to push. And the reason I'm going to push is because I can play the jump shot and I'll be confident of potting it. But the white's going to run away from the two. And it's actually, I think, just as easy to play safe. Or is it? Oh, I don't know. No, I'm going to go for it. Because it should leave me a bank. I think it's left me the bank. Yeah. I like that. That's a good shot. So almost passed, and my natural game is to be aggressive. That wasn't a good shot. I need to crank it up the bottom here. And don't go in off. Don't go in off. Here I'm just going to play. Oh, it's going to have to be a straight screw, which I didn't really want to do. I got a bit lucky where the white's finished. And this is going to be just aiming for the cushion, no further. And I got away with that. So again, potentially not in bad shape for this run out. Here I just want to leave a little bit of angle. Not too much, just enough to stun onto the cushion, just like that. So you get the insurance of if you did make a mess of it, you've got the easy 10. So I thought it was going to be 3-0. I forgot about the rather disgusting combo. But that's a good break. The only problem is instantly is the 6. So what I might do is play on the 3. If I've got an angle to come from the 3 into the 6, I might take it. I would have probably been better off leaving an angle to open up, and that's always a danger. Bit over ambitious, that one, and I've gone in off. Whoops. Unfortunately, I've left an easy combination between the 6 and the 10. All the computer's got to do is to play a deep screw here, get behind the 6 ball, and the rest is academic. And that wasn't the shot, but I still think you can come cushion first. Now, whether the computer works that out, I don't know. He's not going to do it. But that was the shot there. But he's got second prize if he hasn't only fouled. Let's just have a look at that again. Yep, as you see there, if you go for zoom right in and replay, damn, you'll see the 10 just move a little bit. So that was a really bad shot, because that should never have happened. So I should, pending a disaster, take 4-1 lead. Now here there's a number of options. I'm going to take the safest one, which is to move the white the least, because you should never miss this shot. The only danger is to nick the cushion on the way past, so I would rather play a little bit thinner and make sure of it in the top corner. So we do have a ball on the break, but the white's gonna have to get a little nick. Now here, what I was trying to do there, right? I was trying to just get it off the where was it? Down there. That cushion there. In the pocket, he's just part of the green. That'll be simpler. Let the spin go around the angles and bring the white back towards the ball. I think it was a two. Didn't work. The spin didn't take, so nightmare. Apologies for the grim description on that one. So a nice run out so far by Mad Max. That's going to be good. That's going to be game. 4-2. No friends for Mad Max, so we need. I've got to get past the middle pocket here. Didn't quite get there, but I'll play a combo onto the 9, which is what I'm going to do. The 5 is a clear problem, but I can get on it. It's got to be quite precise. I'm just trying to work out what angle am I going to need. I think as long as I've got any angle, I can get across the table for the long 5. I'm not going to try and get close. I want to just screw it back kind of to where it is. So anywhere kind of just short, that's probably all I could hope for, really. And just load up the bottom. I'll take that. Just got past. Watch how close I get to the 7. Hits a 7, it's a nightmare. Hits a 7, it's a nightmare. Oh dear. Need that to get past the 8. This has to make it. It has to make it. Just. Nice and safe. That was a good shot. So 5-2, we got the hill first. And that's straight enough. Not good. Upset with that one, that was poor. But look, I've got lucky with the two. He has to move this. He probably will, and he's played that very well. Nearly missed that one. Got a bit of a problem to the 3 and the 4, down to the 5. See how he navigates that one. Good. Whew. Riding on the edge of disaster, and that's beautiful. Now here I would play with running spin. Well, that's one way to do it. I wouldn't have done that. I would have played with top right and gone round for the 8 in the corner next to where his cue is. But Mad Max just showing us what the computer can do. Very, very nice run out in this 8th rack. 5-3. So I'm just now hoping for a chance, and nearly got one. That doesn't want to drop for the computer. Will he go for the combo? Yep. 5-4. Has he got a shot on the one? He has, and look at the four ball. Could be a 5-5. So he runs a three packer on us, and it's to Hill. Am I going to get first goal? I am, and there's no shot. I always think playing this is safer. Now I need this to bounce because it's going to be going out of line. Because Mad Max is brilliant at safeties. Have to go for this because the seven's going to stop the Oh, it's a good one. He's played it well. Don't jump it. Leave it on. Bounce. Fouled. Ah, painful. Oh, give over. Well, I'm not quite sure how I lost that one, to be honest. But a great match, and I hope you enjoyed it. I will do another. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye for now.